to Rogues, aka Rules of Wuxia, where we explore the elements of Chinese martial arts cinematography. I'm your host, Lisa. Today on Rogues, we have Beggars, a Cute Monk, and a Geography Lesson of China. This program is classified M. In today's society, we base our identity on the university we studied at, the company we work for, or even the church group we belong to. Similarly, the people of Wuling also base their identities on the martial arts sect or clan they are a part of. Wuling means the martial arts community. In today's episode, we will be talking about martial arts clans. Here I would like to thank one of my subscribers for giving me this idea. There are many martial arts clans that we can talk about. First up today, we have Gai Bang, or the Beggar's Sect. In Wuxia film and television, if you ever see a beggar getting more than 3 seconds of screen time, then chances are he or she is from the Beggar Sect. The strength of this sect is their ability to gather and spread information, all thanks to their wide and outspread communication network. Their signature kung fu includes the dragon slaying 18 palms featured in Rogues Episode 3, as well as the dog beating staff technique. One cannot make a video about martial arts clans without mentioning the Shaolin sect. According to Wikipedia, Shaolin is one of the largest and best-known Orthodox clan in Wuling. Its members are predominantly monks who, apart from training in martial arts, also follow Buddhist customs. There is a famous saying, "Tian xia wu gong chu Shaolin," meaning Shaolin is the origin of all martial arts. Wudang is another orthodox sect and major power in Wuling. Its members are priests who follow Taoist customs in addition to training in Kung Fu. Their martial arts include the internationally famous Tai Chi. An interesting thing to note is that the Wudang sect is named after the Wudang Mountains, where their home base is situated. It is common for a martial arts clan to derive its name from the mountain that it is based in. Here is a list of these clans. Hua Shan,
上岩可以官人来做, 千里发功, 有杀气,
蜀山,
红红剑吧，举世无双，独步武林。青城，峨眉，
吃肉，一剑杀了他。
As you can see, China has a lot of mountains you can visit. So after listing all these so-called orthodox clans, you may be wondering, are there any unorthodox clans? Well, of course, Wuxia stories need bad guys too. Remember the beautiful Invincible East from Rogues Episode 2 who castrated himself? Well, he or she was the leader of 日月神教, the Sun Moon Divine Cult, and its members insanely worshipped him or her.
Wu Gang教徒, 英雄万岁, 万岁, 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 万岁.
独角 The Five Poison Sets, is another cultish group whose members are highly trained in using poison in combat. Other cults in wuxia fiction include Yi Hua Gong, the Shifting Flower Palace, which consists of only female members who are beautiful yet deadly. Some martial arts clans were said to be politically motivated, so it's kind of hard for us modern day people to label them as good or bad. For example,Mingjiao, stemming from Manichism, was a group that was completely fictionalized in the story of the Heavenly Sword and Dragon Saber, where they were said to have aided the overthrow of the Yuan Dynasty.
Da Yuan Qiao Wei Zhen Tian Ha, Yao Lam Zi Bek, Zi Dong Zi Si.版图之大，旷古绝今，就凭你一个张无忌，斗得赢元朝咩？
元朝暴政不得民心，我明教替天行道，早已喺各处发动义军抗元，系千万民心所归。你哋系斗得过天下嘅民心咩？
红花会 ，The Red Flower Clan。Attempted to overthrow the Qin dynasty because its leader was apparently the emperor's brother. It's complicated. Obviously, there are many other martial arts clans who I haven't mentioned. Which martial arts clan is your